against Louisville defense every day. It makes us as an offense have to come to practice ready to work every day. You know, you got guys like Lorenzo Malden, D. Mount, B.J. DeBose, you know, up front that us as offensive line we feel are pretty good. So we know that every day we have to come with our hard hat and ready to work, and the defense pushes us, you know, to make sure that we do that, and we try to do the same for them. You know, going on the road for the first time, I try to make sure that we as a team, we focus on the details, focus on the small things, you know, focus on being able to stay locked in a full game, you know, and that starts being able to stay locked in for a full practice, taking that day by day this week as we go into practice and we start preparing for Virginia. And just try to get ready for some of those situations that may come up when we get to Virginia, and our ability to be able to handle those different situations, because we all know, you know, every game of football has adversity points. So being able to deal with those points. Most definitely. You know, it's always good to win at home, but it's even better to go out in someone else's stadium and be able to pull out the win. So, you know, we try to trickle that down to the younger guys that just got here, you know, our style and the way we do things, that we go on the road and we take care of business.
What do you believe has made this program so good on the road?
Really, our preparation. You know, not to say that we don't prepare for home games, but, you know, the importance of preparing to go to someone else's stadium, you know, maybe the environment, you know, maybe the things that they might do, you know, when they're at home, you know, just getting prepared. That's the biggest thing that we've done in the past and that we will continue to do, you know, going on the road.
Over the past 3 years, how many times have you heard that you have to pack your offense, you have to pack your defense?
Yeah, yeah. It's probably something that's instilled in my brain, you know. You know, went on the road, we had to pack off the face of the game. But it's very, very true. It's a true statement. So, we know this week we have to be better at offense, you know, because they do have a good defense that we will be going up against this week. And defensively, we have to make sure that we know what they can do offensively. And then on special teams, we have to make sure we make a difference on special teams, because, you know, special teams is something that's always overlooked, but it makes a big difference in the game. So we have to get ready in all three phases.
They like to bring a lot of pressure.
I've watched a little film, you know, mostly just to get a feel of the guys and how they play, you know, tendencies and everything. You know, as we get further into the week, you know, we'll figure out those different tendencies that they like to do on defense and what types of pressure they like to bring and, you know, what guys that we have to key on, different things, and we'll be ready for whatever they bring.
From what you've seen, is their athleticism, size, experience, what's been the most important?
It's a combination of both. I mean, all those things, really. You know, their defensive line, they have two pretty good pass rushers on the edge and the defensive ends. They have some pretty stout guys on the inside. And it really comes down to us as offensive line doing our job, you know, making sure that we protect the passer when it's time to protect the passer, and making sure that we open holes when it's time to run the ball. Other than that, I think we'll be fine.
Pretty adamant that Will's the starting quarterback. There's so much attention to the way Reggie played the other night. Do you have any worries about Will and his?
Oh, no. Will knows he's our starter, and he knows that we're behind him, you know, 100%. You know, Reggie did come out, and he did some good things. He did some good things, and that was, you know, trying to get Reggie ready for the future, you know, however much he may play in the future. But Will knows that he's the starter, and we all know that Will's the starter, and we're completely behind Will.
Seen Will develop over the last 6 months or so. What's changed about
confidence. You know, every day that we go out there on the practice field, you can see Will, you know, he's starting to build his confidence more. You know, he's taking control of the huddle. You know, that was something that he lacked, I felt, you know. He does, and, you know, his confidence is the biggest thing that I felt he's improved on. Just being confident and knowing what to do, really. As you know, we've been in a new system for however many months, and, you know, the biggest thing of being able to play fast, play confident, is knowing what you're supposed to do. So, you know, I think as we'll, you know, grasp more of the concept of what we have to do in this offense, then he became more confident, and I feel like that's what he's doing now. He's got his head around what we're trying to do as an offense, and which is allowing him to be able to play faster, be able to play more confident.
Veteran players react to Coach Strong's.
Oh, you know, we wish Coach Strong the best. You know, we seen that he did struggle and they ended up losing the game Saturday. But, you know, us as vets, we know, you know, every football game is hard to win, you know. But we do wish Coach Strong the best, and, you know, we have to focus on what we have to do at hand, you know, which is this week, Virginia.